Ayurveda deals with two important aspects, swastasya swastirekshanam adhurasya vikara prashamanam cha, that is, maintaining the health of a healthy person and to cure the disease of a diseased person. In order to cure the disease of a diseased person, one should know the basic five things known as Nidana Panchaka. In order to go through a correct line of diagnosis and treatment in Ayurveda, one should go through these five steps called Nidana Panchaka. So, Nidana Panchaka is that much important in the field of Ayurveda. They are Nidanam, Purva Rupam, Rupam, Samprapti and Ubhashaya.
First one, Nidanam, etiology. Nidana has been used in two different meanings. First one, diagnosis of diseases. Second one, etiology of diseases. Diagnosis of a disease. Nidana means the name of a disease such as jwara, kasa, etc. Nidana means arriving at a definite diagnosis of a disease. Nidana means arriving at a conclusive diagnosis of a disease. After considering and correlating several factors like etiology, symptomatology, pathology and investigations. These three definitions of Nidana convey more or less the same meaning, that is Nidana. Etiology of a disease. Nidana means the factors responsible for producing disease, that is etiological factors. Second one, Purva Rupam, prodromal symptoms. Before the actual onset of a disease, some symptoms develop and they give clues about the forthcoming disease. Such symptoms are called prodromal symptoms or Purva Rupa. Purva Rupa, which do not clarify the peculiarity of dosha taking part in the samprapti of disease, hence these symptoms are few and not clear. Purva Rupas are the best clues regarding the developing of a disease and help to detect the pathology as early as possible and try to control and cure it. Rupa, signs and symptoms. Rupa means symptoms of the actual manifestation of disease. At this state, dosha-dosha samurchana would have commenced. The rupas may change from time to time according to the progress or retrogress of the disease. When the purva rupas become prominent, clear and regular, they are called rupas.
Clear-cut appearance of complication of disease, that is Upadrava, also become part of Rupa. Rupa gives information about vitiated dosha and the qualities of its vitiation. Rupa indicates the site of actual pathology in the body. Confirmation of disease and its type is alone done with the help of Rupa. Rupa is also helpful in differential diagnosis as well as its prognosis. As Rupa indicates vitiation of dosha indirectly, they indicate the cause of vitiation also. Rupa is also helpful in deciding the line of treatment.
Fourth one, Samprapti, pathogenesis. In this stage, the importance of nature and manner of vitiation of dosha and also the nature and manner of its spread in the body among dadus and srodas is described. In here, following things can happen. nature and manner of vishesha of dosha, type of vishesha of doshas, vishesha and etiological factors.
Fifth one, Upashaya and Anupashaya.
A judicious application of drug, diet, practices prescribed jointly or severally, either antagonistic to the cause or to the disease or to both. When these things produce relief to symptoms, it is called Upashaya. When it aggravates, it is called Anupashaya. So, it is a trial and error treatment. When the symptoms appear in a feeble strength or do not appear at all, method of Upashaya, trial and error method of treatment become helpful to arrive at a correct diagnosis. Then, what is the difference between Upashaya and Chikilsa? When a treatment applying drug, diet and practices is used for the purpose of diagnosis, it is called Upashaya, and when it is continued after the confirmation of the diagnosis, it is called Chikilsa.
So, by this Nidana Panchaka, we can go through a correct line of diagnosis and treatment.